Milad, in item one, I just have a small thing to say. Milad, I appear in item 1.33. Milad, that's SLP number 4863 of 2023. I filed an IA 109308 of 2024 pleading for detagging, Milad. And the reason for detagging...
No, let's not repeat it again and again. Every time they scuttle it this way, let them send a mail. We will inform the court if whether it will be detagged or not.
Just send a mail to the AG, he'll examine it and he can tell us it has to be detagged. We'll detag it there.
Very well. I'm so grateful.
May I start now?
Yes.
Sorry. Just for the purpose of housekeeping, Lordship. Lordship, there are more than 631 matters listed before your Lordship. And these are arising from various high court, and each high court has given judgment in respect of assessment year based on those particular issues. So, if you are just, I've just given a one page, Your Lordship.
But I will not die. Let me clarify what my friend.
Let me respond.
I have given already, I have circulated even before vacation. The principle of law will remain the same one way or the other. Either we succeed or we lose. And it can be applied, my lord, for every assessment year. I have given a brief note already to the court and to my friend.
Just give me one.
But no, you have to give me one.
What is the date on which we had last heard the matter? Because we can track our notes then.
No, it was heard March.
Was heard last.
And just give the date, my lord. 2/5/2024. And it was heard for more than one half days. My friend is now trying to divide. But let me assure my friend.
Which is that substantive hearing before the 2nd of May?
Not BSC dates 19/3/2024 and 2/5 very briefly. But these two are substantive hearing. 19/3/2024 and 20/3/2024.
Yes, I got it. 19 plus.
Money was on.
May I just explain to you? This point, you know.
Let him just at least open.
Just, yeah, 1 minute. I will not take more than one minute just to explain. These are 630 odd petitions.
Yes.
And there are 5 assessment years.
Yes.
5 different assessment years.
Yes.
Issue arising in 12, 13, and 13, 14 is different than what is in 14, 15, or the reasoning given. And 15, 16, and 16, 17, 15, 16 is different than 12, 13, 13, 14. And 16, 17, 17, 18, there are 2 issues. Different high courts have taken on that issues. By and large, all high courts are in favor of the revenue assessee, except in 12, 13, 13, 14, where all high courts are in favor of the assessee, except Delhi High Court and revenue issue. So when my friend is addressing the court, my suggestion will be, only request will be, just for the purpose, because there are 31 advocates which are lined up for arguments. Now, when I tried to reach out to each one, I could find out somebody will be arguing for 12, 13, somebody will be arguing for 14, 15, or somebody will be arguing for 15, 16. So there is bound to be a little confusion because one will be addressing the issue which is relevant for 12, 13, and then next advocate will be arguing the issues in 16, 17, 17. And these issues are different. And that's why I just made a 2-page chart on this issue, so that these are the 4 categories in which this petition need to be divided. And based on that, then issues by 12, 13, 13, 14, these are the high court judgment, which will be subject matter of the DCM. That's all.
Okay. Since you have prepared this short, this is your note, no?
Yes, sir. May I assist, my lord, a straight answer? But fortunately, even though there are 31 counsels, the ASG is only one in this matter. So for all the 5 assessment years. As against all.
But ultimate Rama and Ram was supported by the...
I mean,
but when he
pays calculation,
you're not alone.
So, 1:31.
He doesn't want a compartment in this manner, it's up to him. But we will proceed in this compartment.
When we close the submission.
It's kind permission. Proceed. 16 is something which is completely unconnected because what we are concerned with today is.
So we'll deal with it separately.
Yes.
Because that is not something which is related to TOLA, COVID at all. These are all under the old scheme, regular reassessment.
All right. We've got now the drift of yours.
Yeah. We have filed a brief note on this year-wise. Well, I will deal. The apprehensions of my friends will be well addressed. Let them not jump.
Okay.
I've addressed it in my brief note too. All the 5 years I've captured it. But please, so let me first place the legal position first. And then we'll apply it every year. That's Lordship will decide the legal principle and its application per assessment year. That's the matter. Matter ends there. But may I start now? Will your Lordship be kind enough to let me recapitulate in 5 minutes, Lord, what the issue is, and then show the provisions of law? Will Lordship be permitted?
Yes.
But we had a old regime of 148 prior to 1/4/2021. The cutoff date is 1/4/2021.
Perhaps for the third or fourth time you are...
In fact, I was telling Mr. Sridharan,
Lord... So now I'm not making fresh notes. I'm reading what you had said last time. If there's something last time, I remember in May, I was adding in small handwriting what additional things you were saying. So I'll do the same thing now in my notes.
Please, Lord.
I can't read the whole notes.
In the lighter way, in two matters, you are yet to stake off in your Lordship's court in spite of our best effort. One is TOLA, another is JET. We don't know which is pulling
JET,
the other.
Now, JET we will take up next week for sure. Today, this next 2 days, we'll finish off TOLA.
I will not complete TOLA. It's a simple legal issue. My friends need not apprehend whatever. I have only one question needs to be addressed. Bottom line question is whether TOLA has to be read into the proviso to section 149, new 149 or not.
All right. Now, you can just start. Give us a quick backdrop of the matter.
Will the Lordship be kind enough, Lord, to come to?
So you were saying that prior to 31.3.21, reopening was governed by sections 147 to 149 and 151.
Yes.
And 4 year was the normal period and 6 years the extended period.
Correct. Will the Lordship, therefore, well, I'll just recapitulate that. Page numbers. Lord, 352 is 147. Page 352 is section 147.
And 354 is 149.
355 is 149. Where, my Lord, who is the approving authority? And, my Lord, 148 is at page 354.
Yes.
So, my Lord, income escaping assessment, two divisions, less than 4 years, my Lord, 4 years and 6 years. 6 years, my Lord, is the extended period if there is suppression, etc., etc. That's a broad classification. But Lord, what is important is, please come to page 420, Supreme Court in GKN Drive Shaft. But there was no procedure involved after an 148 notice was issued and before, my Lord, a commencement of an assessment proceedings. So GKN Drive Shaft, my Lord, at page 421, paragraph 5. Will you also be kind enough? Yes. We see no justifiable reason to interfere with the order under challenge. However, we clarify that when a notice under 148 of the Income Tax Act is issued, the proper course of action for the notice is to file, return, and if he so desires, to seek reasons for issuing notices. The assessing officer is bound to furnish reason within a reasonable time. On receipt of reasons, the noticee is entitled to file objections to the issuance of notice and the assessing officer is bound to dispose of the same by passing a speaking order. The instant case, as reasons have been disclosed in these proceedings, the assessing officer has to dispose of the objection if filed by passing a speaking order before proceeding with the assessment and in respect of the above set 5 years. So, my Lord, from a 148 notice, before commencement of hearing, a layer of natural justice was
added. Three things, Mr. Venkatraman. If you go by GK and drive shafts, one, once the notice under 148 is issued, the assessee must file a return. And if the assessee so desires, he would seek reasons for issue of notice. Two, assessing officer is bound reasons within a reasonable time. And three, on receipt of the reasons, the assessee is entitled to file objections to the same by passing a speaking order before proceeding with the assessment, correct?
Perfectly. So, Lord, this was how it was?
Amended regime from 1/4/2021.
I'll come to the amended regime in a minute's time. One last provision I need to show, my Lord.
Either under 148 capital A.
But can I show the one old law? Please come to 151 at 350. I'm sorry.
Trying to track down your compilation once again.
Yes. Oh, yeah. I'm referring to my compilation.
Now we have got the section 147.
Yes. Lord, will your lordship be kind enough to see?
You want us to see GKN?
GKN, my lord, I'll take you. Your lordship is at 420. At 421, has captured, my lord, the 3 points of para 5. Absolutely, those are the three ingredients. We see no justifiable reason to interfere with the order under challenge. However, we clarify that when a notice under 148 of the Income Tax Act is issued, the proper course of action for the notice is to file the return if he so desires to seek reason for issuing notices. The assessing officer is bound to furnish reason within a reasonable time. On receipt of the reasons, the notice is entitled to file objections to the issuance of the notice. An assessing officer is bound to dispose of the same by speaking order. In the instant case, as reasons have been disclosed in these proceedings, the assessing officer has to dispose of the objection if filed by passing a speaking order before proceeding with the assessment in respect of the above said 5 years. So three tests: filing a return, issuing a notice, receiving of an objection.
Right.
This was the process under the old law. One last provision, my lord, 149 and 151, you may see for a minute. 355 is 149, where, my lord, they have put the two less than 4 years and more than 4 years. Based on the fact, my lord, if it's going to be not mere escapement of assessment, but escapement resulting in suppression, then the extended period of 6 years, just broadly speaking at the moment. So 355, my lord, deals with 149. And my lord, please come to 356, 151, which deals with who is the approving authority under the old regime. If it is going to be 6 years period, then the principal chief commissioner or the chief commissioner or the principal commissioner or commissioner. If it is going to be the 4 year period, then my lord, shall be issued who is below the rank of a joint commissioner, unless the joint commissioner is satisfied on the recent record by such a result that fit case for issuance of such a notice. These are the approving authority, because these are the only two legal issues which needs to be resolved. So in short, before I go to the new regime, what 147 allows reassessment of escapement. Yes. 149 prescribes 4 years and 6 years. 151 prescribes the approving authority, depending on whether it's a 4 year period or a 6 year period. Third step. And fourth step is, my lord, a 148 notice. And the fifth step is, my lord, follow GKN drive. This was the regime prior to 14-2020.
Can you just repeat that?
Yes. My lord, A147. Prescribes the parameters for reopening the assessment, where income has escaped assessment. Putting it into two buckets, escapement in its ordinary sense and, my lord, escapement resulting in suppression of material, broadly speaking. The language is not fairly fine, but this is a broad category. So 147 is the first step. 149 is the second step, which provides two time limits, 4 years and 6 years. Correspondingly, 151 prescribes who are the approving authorities, sanctioning authorities rather, for issuance of the notices. For 6 year, there is a category of officers, and for 4 year, there is a category of officers. There is two sets of officers become the sanctioning authorities. Fourth step is, my lord, issuance of a 148 notice. And the final step, my lord, is follow the ratio of GK and drive time. This is how, my lord, the old regime worked.
Right.
Now, my lord, the new regime has a few important features which your lordship may have to, I may be permitted to capture provision-wise. My lord, there is no dispute on either side. The new law takes effect from 14-2021. And secondly, it travels back in time. That's an agreement both of us have. It will also apply for past assessment years. It's not that it is applicable only from the assessment year 22-23 or the financial year 21-22. It applies even for the earlier periods. It is on that basis, Palot, when I refer, Asish Agarwal was also rendered. When you travel back in time, then revenue should also be allowed to travel back in time and cure the notices. That was the principle in which we succeeded in Asish Agarwal. So it travels back in time. There is no controversy on that aspect. These are two. Now, Malot, three, Malot, please come to the new regime at 357, which is the starting point, which is the new 147. And it is fairly narrow in its campus, fairly smaller in its connotation, but wider in its reach compared to the erstwhile 147. We'll do that in some other case. Just for the, if any income chargeable to tax in the case of an assessee has escaped assessments for any assessment year, the assessing officer, well, that's the first caveat. The assessing officer may, subject to the provisions of 148 to 153, assess or reassess such income or recompute the loss or depreciation allowance or any other allowance or deduction from such assessment year, hereinafter referred to in subsection 148 to 153, referred to as the relevant assessment year. For the purpose of assessment or recomputation under this section, the assessing officer may assess or reassess the income in respect of any issue which has escaped assessment, and such issues come to his notice subsequently in the course of the proceedings under this section, irrespective of the fact that the provisions of 148 have been complied with or not. So, Malot, once we start with the process of an assess initiation under 147, then we discover something later in time can still be part of it. Because the process is important rather than factoring everything at the first go. So it's slightly elastic in its content, not relevant for this case, but this architecture. Then, Malot, will you also be kind enough to come to 148? Which is in the next page, 358.
Yes.
Before making the assessment, reassessment or recomputation under 147 and subject to the provisions of section 148A, well, that should be marked. But 147 is subject to 148 to 153. And 148 is subject to 148A. There is a reason for this emphasis, which my lord in due course will submit. And subject to the provisions of section 148A, the assessing officer shall serve on the assessee a notice along with a copy of the order passed if required under clause D of section 148A, requiring him to furnish within such period as may be specified in such notice, a return of his income or the income of any person in respect of which he is assessable under this act during the previous year, corresponding to the relevant assessment year, the prescribed form and verified in the prescribed manner, and setting forth such other particulars as may be prescribed, and the provisions of this act shall so far as may apply accordingly, and as if returns were returned to be furnished under 139. Well, rest is all, my lord. The proviso, I'll just explanation. Proviso also read an explanation. Provided that no notice under this section shall be issued unless there is an information with the assessing officer which suggests that the income chargeable to tax has escaped assessment in the case of assessee for the relevant assessment year, and the assessing officer has obtained prior approval of the specified authority to such notice. So two conditions. I must have prior information, my lord, satisfaction, suspicion, all those things are now gone. Earlier whole regime. My lord, whether it should be suspicion or whether it should be satisfaction, all this is gone. I must have prior information. And my lord, it should be approved. Now, please see the three clauses. For the purpose of this section 148, the information with the assessing officer suggests that the income chargeable has escaped means they have flagged it off. But these are all not relevant at the moment. So this is how, my lord, the format of 148 is when I issue a notice. But this is subject to 148A. Therefore, my lords may come to 148A. Which is brought at 359. So once, my lord, there is an intention to do under 147, the first step, my lord, after taking approval under 140, 15, 51 and the period, I'll come to that last. You start with the process under, my lord, 148A is now, my lord, a legislative mandate of almost JKN driveshaft. In short, what was conceived as a judicial pronouncement additions value to it, no doubt about it. But the essence of GKN's SAF is, my lord, covered in 148A. Because it says, the assessing officer shall, before issuing any notice under 148, conduct any inquiry if required with prior approval of specified authority, etc., provide an opportunity of being heard to the assessee. C, consider the reply of the assessee furnished, if any, in response to the show cause notice. D, decide on the basis of material available on record, including the reply of the assessee, whether or not it's a fit case to issue a notice under 148 by passing an order with the prior approval of the specified authority in the 1 month and so on. So, so my lord, 148 capital A subclause D mandates passing of an order with approval. These are the twin conditions under the new regime. There must be a 148 AD order and, my lord, a sanction for a notice to be issued under 148. And, my lord, it has a proviso, matters under investigation, 132, 132, all that, my lord, we will not have to pass through these buckets. The information is deemed to have been with the officer and he'll proceed thereon. These are exceptions, again, not connected to the present case and therefore not dealt with.